Miller?
Got a spike on the RWR. Strange PRF.
What's wrong?
Control lost. Can't maintain RPM. We're settling.
This is that shot from the trailer. And okay, so this is showing what was happening during the whole thing. Okay. I love how when the trailer came out showing that shot, everyone thought it was Solid Snake next to Liquid. And because Solid Snake was blonde, I believe he dyed his hair during the briefing of MGS1. But I guess that was just a misdirection. So Solid Snake, that's not Solid Snake. Some sort of mantis hallucination. So did Eli hijack Metal Gear when we weren't looking?
Wait.
Thing is, Metal Gear opened up and I couldn't see anyone inside, so I wouldn't think that Eli hijacked it. See, there's no one inside. Oh, this is that shot from the trailer as well. Oh yeah, I remember. The trailer implied that Eli hijacked it though, so I'm not sure what's going on here. This is where it stands up, right? Of course, that weapon is very suggestive. Do I even need to comment? At this point, it's just beating a dead horse.
PRF anomaly. Quick wake is outbound. Deploying the AO for now.
All units, move in!
And this is where he pulls out the whip.
Yeah.
flash. No way. Is he done for?
I will rewrite the records. And I will vanish from human memory.
Using GW.
The thirst for revenge that I have planted will infest the system. No one can stop it now.
What, has he already infected someone with parasite?
Will unleash that thirst unto the future. Major, I'm burning up!
What? That's the end of Skullface? That's how you get...
Boss, get out of there!
That's how he gets taken out? There's not even a boss fight with him? Unless he's still alive, although he looks pretty dead from there. No way, is he really dead? I'm guessing I'm gonna gain control here.
Sahelanthropus. Skullface will have won. His plans will become reality. He won't even need to use nukes. That thing's mere existence would be enough to enslave humanity to the fear of nuclear Armageddon. It would tear the world apart.
I really hope Skullface isn't dead already. I was kind of hoping we would have a cool kind of cowboy duel, some sort of boss fight with him. Okay. that thing is scary. Seriously. Look at that. Jesus Christ. Oh my god. This feels like the first proper boss fight of the game. This is pretty crazy. Okay. I'm telling you, that sequence earlier on in the game where we had to run away from it, that was pretty frightening. This is gonna be intense. When I saw the trailers and I saw this thing, I was thinking to myself, oh man, I can't wait to fight this. That looks like a really cool boss fight. And when I actually had to run away from it earlier on in the game, it was actually just pretty scary. Oh, hello, I see a tank. Oh god. Let's get out of here. See, this is what I want with a boss when it comes to the boss fights. I want the health bar to be there in the corner of the screen. And I want the boss fights to last more than 2 minutes, unlike the quiet fight. Or the fight with Volgin at the Devil's House. See? If the boss fight with Volgin lasted a few, like, 10 or 20 minutes, and the health bar was in the corner of the screen, I would be satisfied. But instead, the fight was over within, like, a minute or 2 minutes, and it wasn't really much of a fight. It was more about you just kind of running. I know I should call and support you. Traff. I could use traff. I guess that would disable it, possibly. I didn't think traff grenades were a thing in this game. Well, I guess they aren't, but unless you call in support, of course. Hey, let's see. Nice. Awesome. Oh, it didn't take off much health. What's it doing now? Quiet isn't much use in this fight, for obvious reasons. Okay, I'm out of ammo. Oh, they're dropping the supply drop. Oh, that's great. That's awesome. Saves me having to call her in, of course. I like that. That's actually very good. I should give them more credit. I'm glad that they thought of that themselves, the developers. I mean, nobody really wants to worry about having to call in the supply drops themselves, do they? What's it doing? Is it resting? What if I, Oh, I thought they were explosive barrels. Never mind. To be honest, I'm not too sure what the weak point is. I'm guessing just the face. Or perhaps the chest. Yeah, that there, in the middle. That kind of looks vulnerable. I did take off a bit of health. Oh! His health is halfway down. That helicopter seems to be doing most of the damage. Oh, that didn't do anything. See that chest there? Ah, didn't hurt it. Gonna blow up. Yeah. I guess I can't use the airstrike during this sandstorm. Oh, did I do that? I didn't choose one. I think they did it. Yeah, I think Mother Base did it without me telling them. That's cool. They did order a supply drop. Where's that gone? I'm not sure where it dropped off to. I'm missing out on some ammo. No. Is he trying to find me? I don't think he knows where I am. Oh, it certainly does. Okay. Instant death. I guess I should have...
Hey, quit kidding around.
Yeah, maybe I should hide behind something next time. Okay, the weak point only seems to pop up when it's about to attack. Mainly when it does the whip thing. That seems to be the best opportunity for you to hit it. Yep, by the time the missiles come down, he's already moved. I knew it. Get in. Oh, it's broken. Oh, jeez. This is a pretty crazy boss fight. Now. Yes. Oh, I'm not sure if that did much damage. Save the helicopter. Oh, what? Really? I guess one of them managed to reach the helicopter. Okay, so this is where he's going to do that massive laser attack or whatever it is. It doesn't seem as if I can run away from it, so I'm going to try and just use something else as cover. I'm hoping this will protect me. Oh, did that go through the tank? The tank seems to be protecting me. Okay. Come on, supply drop or whatever it is. He's about to move. Oh, that's pretty frustrating. I start the smoke. Perhaps if I can find another tank. GMP? For what? Mantis? So Mantis definitely is controlling this thing. What's happening here? I guess it's malfunctioning. Yeah, okay. Seems to be, the weak point seems to show up when he's about to attack with that. If I run into another tank, I think it's safe to assume I'm gonna win this fight. Okay. Seems at that point if you don't shoot Mantis, you're gonna get instant killed. Oh, I had to reload, didn't I? Oh, never mind. Got lucky. Shooting Mantis doesn't seem to take down its health, though. I was kind of hoping another helicopter would eventually come as well, because the other one got destroyed. And those things seem to blow up if you touch them. And I, also, after a while, they seem to blow up anyway. Okay. Really do with another tank. Where's their weak points? I still don't have a definite answer to that. Oh, wait. Where's Mantis? Mantis isn't here. Oh. Almost killed myself. Okay, I'm pretty convinced that's the weak point. And whoa, he's got a flamethrower. Does he have any other surprise attacks I don't know about? Oh, I know, I want it. That's one thing about this game I'll say. Just switching weapons, it can be kind of finicky sometimes when you're in a rush. Just switching weapons, sometimes it's a, when you're in a rush like that, it can be a kind of a bit finicky. Okay, so one more shot should do it. I got the pattern down, I think, for the fight. I pretty much know the strategy. Better reload this ready for when he jumps at me again. Oh, come on, I didn't even touch that. Can I take you out with the assault rifle? That'd be a cool way to end the fight. No, not. Oh! It actually worked. Awesome. That was a really cool boss fight. Although it was really the only boss fight in the whole entire game. The one and only proper boss fight, of course. I'm gonna be honest, I still don't quite understand what's happening here. Because in the trailer, we see Eli jump in to hijack the Metal Gear. But I don't know if that was cut from the game or what, because a lot of things did get cut from the game. I got a feeling we actually aren't going to fight Volgin. We're not going to have a proper boss fight with him. That one encounter we had with him earlier on in the game is the only encounter. I really hope not. So like I said, I like a good boss fight. The sheep running away. I think as far as the Metal Gear, the mech fights in the series goes, that may be the best one. Better than the Ray fight, Rex fight, the Shago Hard, Peace Walker. That might be the best one. That was pretty damn good. Mantis?
Let's see Skullface.
So he's still alive? I got a feeling Mantis is possessing Eli. So Eli is going to get up to some sneaky stuff back at Mother Base. That's the impression I'm getting here. Okay, guess we're gonna get some dying words from here, from him here. I'm actually really disappointed here. I wanted to have a proper boss fight with him. I was imagining some really cool cowboy duel, because he has that weapon he has, you know, the cowboy hat and everything. I think that could have made for a really cool boss fight. Kind of disappointed by that.
There were three. Where's the other?
Very close to you.
What has he? Oh, what? A snake been infected by this? Mantis.
Finish me.
Okay, so Mantis has the last vial. So Mantis is still working on behalf of Skullface. So what was the deal with Metal Gear going apeshit? I was under the impression that Mantis was going rogue and was betraying Skullface by hijacking Metal Gear. But I don't understand why Mantis is even doing this. I guess they'll explain it later. I think I'm supposed to pull the trigger here. It's kind of like the bolts at the end of MGS3. What if I don't pull the trigger? Something else may happen, maybe? Jesus. It seemed as if it was giving me the option to pull the trigger earlier.
Do it yourself.
So had I just pressed the shoot button, would they have just killed Skullface instantly? But because I waited so long, I guess Miller just did that instead. I'm not sure if that was like an optional multi thing.
Boss.
I honestly feel kind of bad for him. Huey did it? I know he's a bad dude, but come on.
I did it! Revenge!
That was an odd moment.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
Enough with the fighting.
Development project.
Ooh,
has been
I can upgrade
added.
My night vision goggles. What else can I do to upgrade them? I guess the battery. And I'm surprised they gave me an S rank. I didn't feel as if I handled that boss fight too well, but apparently that was worthy of an S rank. Okay. Yeah, that was a cool boss fight though. Really dug that. So this is the R and D platform. Another shot from the trailer.
Anyone can give up his fight by laying down arms. But the feeling of holding a gun, that we'll never forget. Like our lost limbs, the sensation lingers.
The story feels pretty much over at this point. Although we still got Mantis. With the vial, so I guess that's the final plot thread they have to close.
Here she comes! Here she comes!
This D-dog that I've never once used so far. Oh, okay. It's Kaoya in the Metal Gear, I bet. Why let it go to waste, eh? Might as well take it back here. Oh, I really hope when I'm exploring Mother Base, I can just see that standing about as well. That'll be really cool, if you can actually see that just standing there in the ocean. Oh, they're not in the ocean then, I guess by here.
Missing hands. We stand tall on missing legs. We stride forward on the bones of our fallen. Then, and only then, are we alive. This pain is ours, and no one else's. The secret weapon we wield, out of sight. We will be stronger than ever. For our peace.
So this is where that shot from the trailer comes from. Everyone was convinced that Skullface was working with Big Boss because of this shot in the trailer. But this is the context.
Unleash that thirst unto the future. Those were his last words.
Cause.
Pretentious to the end. Still. Doesn't feel like this is over. And I'll never be whole again.
Only six. Blood. Okay, so this is very obviously the fake ending. I believe there's three different endings. So this is kind of like the first ending, obviously. But the fourth and final ending is actually completely removed from the game. I am aware of that. The final boss fight and final ending is actually removed from the game, along with many other things, because like I said, the game is unfinished. Oh. We may yet get to see Eli hijack Metal Gear. Okay, so Mantis is controlling Eli at this point. We still don't know why Mantis was working for Skullface, or why did he hijack Metal Gear to begin with. I think it's safe to skip these credits. I don't think I'll be missing anything by doing this. If the game lets you. There might be something at the end of these credits, so I don't quite want to skip these. I'll wait till the end. As? I did see Paz in the trailer, so yeah, well, she hasn't popped up yet. I guess she'll pop up after the ending, or maybe a bit later, I don't know, because the game is, I think we're about halfway through the game, but like I said, from what I understand, the second half of the game is basically every mission you've already done on a higher difficulty. It's something along those lines, I don't know the specifics. Zero hasn't spoken either. We haven't heard his voice. He did have a line in the trailer, but I don't know. Maybe he got cut. Maybe it's yet to come. Okay, I ended up just skipping the credits in the end because they were taking quite a while. So we've got some new tapes, I guess I'll listen to them next. Raven's Sword, that's one of the PMCs from MGS4. Okay, nuclear weapons. Trial. A lot of S ranks. What's this? A trailer? Oh,
sorrow to the heartless sea. I won't see you in his ashes.
It's a trailer for the second chapter.
This man acted as accomplice to the attack on Mother Base.
Why are you here? Revenge against the boss.
I'm not like you!
I think it is time you knew.
I'll go alone.
Boss, what are you...
We can't afford to lose anyone else.
What if she's a spy?
What if I'm a spy? Are you?
Kill him! What should we do, boss? Just give the order.
You are right. He is not one of us.
Boss.
Snake?
Okay, chapter 2 is looking pretty sweet. I'm actually pretty hyped.
Attention! Diamond Dogs! Even with Skullface dead, our brothers are unavenged. And the phantom pain he brought us lives on. Cypher is still out there. We know they planted spies, parasites among us. Watch the man to your left, to your right. Assume nothing. Report everything. It's the only way to protect ourselves. From here on out, you will be my eyes. The deadliest enemy's right here in our midst. And they will get no mercy.
I have heard that the story is supposed to be really disappointing overall, but I'm excited. That trailer made it look really, really cool. Alright.
Even with Skullface dead, our pain is still right with us. We need more strength.
Unit function edit.
We need more men.
Development project.
Diamond Dogs needs
added
to be bigger. Missions have come in too. We still have a long road ahead of us.
The boss is watching you. That's cute.
Please attention.
Okay, can we develop any more struts? Nope. Nowhere near. We need a lot of fuel. And they really... The fuel, it should be more common if it's going to be required for all of these platforms. This is crazy.
Please specify.
Oh, here we go. The final upgrade for the tranquilizer.
Sign
will
set shortly.
What the? Look at that. Light amplification up. Exposure correction up. Okay. Cool. Sounds good.
Please specify.
Can I make this
project
as fast as possible yet? No. Got a long way till then. Okay. What missions do we got?
Select a mission.
Yeah, see? This is where we have to start replaying the old missions. I guess they ran out of development time. The drama between Konami and Kojima prevented them from finishing the game on time, so now they're just making you replay the older missions. That's a new one, though. That looks... yeah. But these are repeats, but that one's a new one. Okay. Oh, check that out. You can see Eli sunbathing on the roof there. Well, it's not sunbathing, but just chilling. Okay, next thing to do is listen to all the tapes. We've got quite a lot there as well. Oh wait, wait for Miller to stop speaking.
With a nuclear deterrent, even if you're discovered while infiltrating a rival PF's FOB, most PFs won't dare retaliate. But you, of all people, know how dangerous it can be to have nuclear weapons. So will you add nukes to our arsenal as a deterrent? Or will you take them away from other PFs and dispose of them to help build a world that's free of nuclear weapons? I'll leave that decision up to you.
Emmerich didn't go with depleted uranium for Sahelanthropus' armor because of its strength.
He had nukes in mind.
Exactly. It's meant to use its body as the fuel component for a nuclear weapon. Sahelanthropus uses built-in uranium enrichment archaea to melt its own body, and extract uranium-235 from the depleted uranium in its armor. Those archaea perform the enrichment in an extremely short time. The concentration jumps by a factor of several hundred, from 0.2% to over 90%, the end result being highly enriched weapons-grade uranium. Sahelanthropus' body itself becomes a nuclear bomb. Emmerich says if it were to self-destruct, the nuclear yield would be somewhere in the region of 15 kilotons. Since you need about 50 kilograms of highly enriched uranium to trigger a nuclear reaction, that would mean Sahelanthropus contains something like 23 tons of depleted uranium.
That's not very much.
No, it isn't. That's about what you'd expect to find in a main battle tank's armor. The point is, it can be transported anywhere, even use its conventional weaponry on the battlefield, and the international community will never suspect a thing. I just received word from the R&D team and the transport team out of Afghanistan. They finished installing Sahelanthropus on the base. It's ours now.
All right. Don't let any of the staff touch that thing. Especially Emmerich.
Of course. That guy's crush on Sahelanthropus is beyond a joke. Guess he really wants to see his tech stand on its own two legs this time.
That's not gonna happen.
I know it. So you've got no plans to make it operational again?
Damn right.
Boss, I want to hear it straight from you.
Hear what?
What the hell do you want with that thing? The drive is busted. It's not like it has a nuke on board. Even if the metallic archaea could turn it into a nuclear weapon, all it can do is self-destruct. Sahelanthropus just isn't a weapon anymore. It'll draw unwanted attention without even being a deterrent.
I know.
The weapon's development strut sank 2 feet under that thing's wake. That's 1 year's drop in a single night. We've started on reinforcing the strut, but there's no guarantee it'll hold up if a storm hits.
I know that too.
Boss, why keep it?
It's a mark. Us Diamond Dogs, we don't have a country to call home. That means we have no past, nothing to prove that we lived. Every one of us threw it all away when we came here. Sahelanthropus is a symbol to show that the likes of us brought at least one crisis to its end.
A mark in history. So we can't just fade away.
It's of no practical use to us. But we still need it.
A symbol of what we've done. I'm glad I sounded you out on this. Snake, on behalf of all of us, I want to thank you.
I don't need gratitude. I need security. Keep Emmerich away from that thing.
Keep Eli away from it. Never mind Huey.